Hi, I'm Walt Grayson. Mississippi is blessed with wonderful resources, especially abundant water. Our future quality of life and economy are tied to how well we protect and restore our natural resources. If you'd like to kayak our quiet rivers and bayous, fish in one of our many lakes and ponds, or maybe just enjoy a sunset as the oranges and reds are reflected by the water. In one way or another, we all value quality water. Our lakes, rivers, streams, and wetlands and coastal waters, including the surrounding land, require our care to ensure the next generation receives this blessing too. Join me as we visit some friends in North Mississippi who have come together around their river.
I'm Suzanne Langley. I'm a resident of Hudsonville, Mississippi, and that's just north of Holly Springs. The neighbors in this whole community all felt very protective about what they discovered when we all moved out here. We are at the headwaters of the Coldwater River. What we were very pleased to do is to work with our local environmental organization, which is Strawberry Plains Audubon Center here, as they identified and helped us understand what natural treasure that we had here. And we had community meetings and decided that we really wanted to participate in protecting this fabulous asset.
The good work of my colleagues at Strawberry Plains Audubon Center, they're focusing on the upper Coldwater River and really the immediate lands around the headwaters. To work with landowners in riparian land management practices and reestablishing forests along the streams, in managing the flow of water so we don't have excess sedimentation, and really getting together a good group of people who understand their own responsibility to protecting the watershed around them for the health of a lot of birds and wildlife, but also for the communities around these waters.
The thing that makes the Hudsonville landowner stewardship a really exciting project is we know that in Hernando, on the other end of Coldwater River, that there's an urban area that is, you know, devoted to protecting the water quality there. So it's just not an isolated project here, you know, because it is in our backyard and we want to protect our backyard. We know that what we're doing to protect the headwaters actually contributes to the quality of water for all the communities downstream.
What Suzanne's been talking about is the Coldwater River watershed or drainage basin. A watershed is all the land area that drains to a particular river or stream. The boundary of the Coldwater River watershed is determined by the highest points in the landscape around the river. The hilltops and ridges define the watershed and work in the same way that the top edge of a bathtub defines the area from which the water flows down the drain. All the rain that lands within those hilltops and ridges that doesn't soak into the ground will become runoff and flow downhill from the headwaters to the Coldwater River, onto Archibutla Lake, and eventually to the Gulf of Mexico. Percent forest cover is a leading indicator of watershed health. As land use changes from forest to cropland or urban areas, the amount of stormwater runoff increases. This increase must be managed to minimize its impacts.
Hi, I'm Tiffany Hurd, and I have the honor of representing DeSoto County, Olive Branch, Horn Lake, and South Haven as their stormwater project manager. And we're here at a subdivision that has been under development for a little over 2 years, and it's been one of the major subdivisions to have stormwater complaints lodged against it, not just for stormwater quality issues, but also for the quantity of stormwater that's now leaving this site. There are thousands of these storm drains in DeSoto County and in the Coldwater River watershed. And as you can see, we've got a lot of silt here in the street gathering in front of the storm drain that has washed down from many of the lots around here. And with this silt has come grass and roots and a lot of trash. Now, the next time we get a big rainfall, all of this dirt and debris is going to wash into this drain. And from this drain, it will travel through a system of pipes. And what actually makes it to the detention pond will settle there. The problem we have is that a lot of the silt, especially a lot of this dirt, will settle out in the storm drain and cause that drain to lose some of its capacity. If it's half filled with dirt, then it's not going to hold as much water as we need it to, and we'll get some flooding here in the street. One of the biggest problems we have with developed areas in Mississippi is that it increases the amount of impervious cover. Streets and rooftops and other areas where water cannot be absorbed. What we know is that when you increase the amount of impervious cover that you have, you're speeding up the water because there are no plants or grass or soil to absorb any of that rainwater. So you have more water moving across the area because there's nothing to absorb it, but that water also moves a whole lot faster because it doesn't have anything to slow it down. We're down in one of the unnamed tributaries of Hurricane Creek, and Hurricane Creek is the second largest drainage basin that we have here in DeSoto County. And as you can see, we have a good example of what happens when you have too much stormwater and you have stormwater moving far too fast. The water can pick up some pretty heavy debris that we probably don't want here in our creeks. Tires, beer kegs, and all of these things eventually will make their way down to Arkabutla. And many people probably don't know that Arkabutla Lake was originally designed to someday provide all of us with drinking water. And I don't know about you, but I don't exactly want some of this stuff in not only my drinking water, but my children's drinking water.